Hello everybody, Jose Rodriguez here. If you're on a Pro 1000 and you have been refilling it using the so-called auto reset chips that are being sold not only by Precision Colors, well they were, they're no longer being sold because of problems, and as well as other companies. And they realized that they are not working as advertised, okay? So it's not any of these companies' fault because the product was actually published and began to be shipped with the guarantee, if you will, that they would reset when they reach empty. All you had to do was interrupt power, and that is done simply by removing the cartridge, refilling it during that time that you have it outside of the printer. When you pop it back in, power is reintroduced into the chip, and it resets it back to full so that when you look at the actual display, it reads it as full. You can only do one at a time because you have to have a cartridge fully go empty, declare empty, if you will. So what's happening is that a lot of people are reporting problems. Now, so far, assuming from the records that I have access to, over 250 full sets of cartridges have been sold to customers, and yet no one has ever reached the point where a real color needed to be reset. So here's what's happening, and here's the mystery behind this whole affair. Photo black, matte black, gray, and chroma optimizer are the only four colors that I have heard malfunctioning reports on. Does that mean that, well, realize that people will never give, hardly ever give a positive reaction to a product. Only when something goes wrong will you ever see them voice an opinion. And I think that's the case. Those particular four colors, if you want to call them, reside in one of three zones. This printhead is subdivided by three zones. Zone one has four colors. Zone two, four other colors. Three, four other colors as well, totaling a total of 12. Now, those four that I mentioned, photo black, matte black, gray, and chroma optimizer, happen to reside in zone two, or group two, if you will. Why are they subdivided? Well, the reason is so that you can actually pinpoint if a specific color channel is showing signs of blockage, then you don't have to do a global cleaning cycle. You just target that one zone. It saves you on ink, actually. So that's one good thing about the Pro 1000. Pro 10 has similar attributes as well as the Pro 1. The Pro 1, just like this one. Three different zones, four colors each. Now, it seems that only the colors on zone two are being affected, or for all you know, are the only colors that have actually reached empty and people have attempted to reset them. What does that mean? Well, there's so many variables in this little mystery. It could be many things. It could be firmware. I have an older firmware. Everyone else that I have spoken with has a much newer firmware than I do. So if it's not firmware, then maybe it's zone related, okay? And often what will happen, if one chip misbehaves in one zone, it could affect the other three chips within that same zone. Okay, don't ask me how that happens, but it has been reported. And Precision Colors, who is a chip expert, you know, has actually seen this happen, even on an Epson printer. Okay, so what to do? Well, we thought maybe it was a certain batch. Well, currently I am running chips on this printer. All of them have been refilled, okay? And don't make the mistake of saying, well, I already refilled it twice. No, you didn't. You topped it off one time and you installed brand new chips. And of course, all of them were read as full. That's what will happen. They will all be read as full, genuine Canon Pro 1000 cartridges. Each one of the colors that you fill up again after you reach empty and you install the new chip on it will be read as full and genuine. Okay, that's not the problem. The problem comes after one of those colors reaches empty and then it doesn't reset as we thought it would be. In other words, go back to a full level indicated by the level indicator here or on the computer driver. So what else could be going on? Well, if it's not the firmware or it's not the zone, particular zone causing problems, then what could it be? A batch? Well, according to the manufacturer, and there's only one manufacturer in the whole world, of course, in China, they sell to everyone else that sells these chips. There's a couple of companies that I know that are still selling these chips, and, you know, unbeknownst to them, I guess, they just haven't heard back, or maybe they haven't sold enough, or maybe people have not reached empty on any of these cartridges that they have refilled and had these chips installed to. So again, very little data is available at this point. So rather than, you know, just go crazy over this, he just stopped selling these, okay? Ink Owl does not even sell them. They tell you to, when your cartridge, your original OEM cartridge reaches empty, refill it, pop it back in, and then disable ink monitoring. There's a way to do that. Well, that will then not ever show you what your actual ink levels are. So you have to weigh each of the cartridges. In full, it's about 18 grams, and empty is about, you know, 80 grams less. So 32 or 33 grams. So you have to constantly be weighing them at least, you know, every few weeks. Pain in the butt. I would love to have my ink monitoring, so I need chips that would work. Okay. Now, what's the other option? Well, single-use chips. And single-use chips are coming. They're on the way here, you know, slow boat from China, as they say. They will arrive, and then they will be made available. I don't know whether there's going to be any deals made for people who currently bought these or not. I paid $25 a piece for these, my original set. These were provided for me to run an experiment. And so I did not have to pay for these. So anyway, lucky me, right? I'm going to use my Pro 1000 as a total guinea pig. If I kill it, well, that's it. I'm going to be paid for this job, but not enough to replace a printer that may go south on me. Because what I have to do is the following. I have to print till the cows come home. And what I want to do, since I'm already running the original set of chips on here, and they claim that there's no difference between previous batches and today's batches. I don't believe that. So I'm going to continue running these. And then when they reach empty, I'm going to try to reset them. If they do not reset, if they act like the reports that I've been hearing, then we'll go ahead and prepare a second set of cartridges. I'm just going to top these same cartridges up, remove the chips, replace them with new ones. We'll start from fresh again. They will all read full. They will all read as genuine. And I'm going to, again, print like there's no tomorrow. And we will bring some of those colors down. I'm not concerned with photo black, matte black, gray, and chroma optimizer. No, that's not what I'm concerned about. I want to see if magenta will reset, or if yellow, light, you know, photo magenta, photo cyan, cyan, blue, red. Those are the colors that are more interesting to me, because no one has ever reported on any actual real color, not just the monochrome inks, but the real colors. I want to know if those reset or they do not. Are you telling me that no one has emptied a yellow cartridge yet since these chips were made available? That's hard for me to actually believe, especially this printer with its cleaning cycles. I'm sure somebody reached empty already in one of those colors. But if they reset, then they have nothing to speak about. They have nothing to complain about. And so you just simply don't hear their voice. So anyway, that is it. So another little hint that I want to give you guys is, don't rely on this LCD to look at your ink levels. Mine read full. They're all the way to the top. When I go to the driver, however, I can tell that some inks are about half. Some inks are about maybe 80% down, and some inks are 20% down. These will begin to show when it's almost low, okay? So don't rely on this. This is just an indicator to show you that all of those channels are being recognized, okay? And so that is it. I had a little problem a while ago where magenta all of a sudden refused to be recognized, okay? I went through all sorts of hoops to try to rectify that problem. It is now fixed, hopefully, I hope. And so hopefully that will not happen again, but that was a little bit odd and kind of not the norm, okay? So anyway, that is it. So I am going to finally find out the actual truth behind these chips. If these don't work, then we will just jump over to single-use chips, period. That'll be our only choice. You want to maintain ink monitoring, then you have to use single-use chips. Or do like some companies recommend, just disable your ink monitoring. And you can continue to refill those original cartridges without having to replace any chip. The chip will still be recognized as a color, a given color, but the levels will simply not be indicated on your driver or on the screen itself. Wish me luck, folks. Wish me luck. This is going to take a hell of a lot of work and a while to perform. So thank you so much. Again, don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. Keep going to the Facebook group and joining. If you haven't done so, there's 22,000 plus subscribers and only 2,250 some so-called members of my group. I'm sure the rest of your subscribers also kind of partake in Facebook, maybe. Some people just don't, but I would appreciate that if you join and just contribute to the crowd that is already there, as they all self-help each other tremendously. And I try to stay away from, you know, little tiny squabbles or arguments. It's not my job to be policing every comment that's made there. It's a pretty free open forum. And all of it is about photo printing. So that is what we eat, breathe, and sleep about. So again, thank you so much for those of you who have joined. Thank you so much for those of you who are using my affiliate link to Amazon.com. Great. Appreciate that. As always, folks, continue printing. Continue enjoying this craft and hobby. Continue producing masterpieces. I've seen a lot of this on my Facebook group. People are really happy with what they are producing, and they are contributing that success to this channel, and that just keeps me going. So thank you so much. Happy printing, everybody. Bye-bye.